Hi, I'm Mrs. Charles with I Spy Science and Wired for Science. Today we're going to talk about geodes. A real geode is a rock that when you crack it open, there's beautiful crystals inside. We're going to make fake geodes today. We're going to put a crystal solution into the eggshell and it'll look like a geode. Here are some of the things you'll need to make eggshell crystal geodes. You'll need Epsom salts, which I have in a measuring cup here, and I have a quarter cup here, Elmer's glue, a paintbrush, and a spoon. The paintbrush actually is optional. And we'll also need some measuring cups. I have three glass ones here, a bowl, food coloring, and eggshells. All right, the first thing you need to do is take an egg and crack it, get rid of the egg yolk, or the whole egg, and then inside it'll be kind of yucky inside, so you want to put a little soap inside, take your finger and wash it good under the sink, and then you'll put it upside down and dry it overnight. I'm using three eggs, but you could actually do more. You'll have enough liquid left to fill more than six half eggshells. Use either your finger or you can use a paintbrush to put glue and spread it around, spread the glue on the inside of the eggshell and the bottom real good. And that will give the Epsom salts something to stick to. Now take your Epsom salts, your quarter cup, and over a bowl so that you don't make a mess on the table, you're going to spoon out and sprinkle some salts into the sides and bottom of the eggs. And of course you can empty the excess out. I just want to make sure it's covered well. And you do this for all of your eggshells. Your eggshells have to dry before going on to the next step. When I practiced this experiment, I noticed that after an hour, some of the salts melted in the glue, and I just poured that out. Then I let my eggshells dry overnight, and I put them in the eggshell carton for easy storing. Now you need adult supervision, as you'll be working with hot water. Boil some water in the microwave, or you can do it on the stovetop. I have a half a cup of hot water in this container. I'm going to spread it into, put half in a two-cup measuring cup, and then the other half in here. Make sure they're about even. The next step is you take 3/4 cup of Epsom salt, and you're going to pour half of it into this container, and you'll do it a little at a time. So I'm going to pour and try and make it about half in each. And you stir it and stir it until it becomes clear. All the Epsom salt dissolves. It wasn't dissolving as fast as I wanted, so I had to microwave my water again. So now I'm going to finish adding the rest of the Epsom salts. I'm showing you one now. I've stirred it and I'm done. This is what it looks like when it's totally saturated with the Epsom salts. You really should do it, pour the Epsom salts in slower than I showed you. It will work better, and do one container at a time. All right, now I'm adding 4 drops of food coloring. And stir that up. The other one I did when I practiced was red, was yellow. This does not look dark enough, so I'm gonna add a little more. Now you can see this is one that has the salt in, or the salt in, and there is a little moisture on the bottom. So I'm just gonna pour that out and then use the egg carton, because then you don't have to touch the hot eggshells. Pour your liquid into your eggs. Whoops. Now you wait. Put your egg carton. I put mine in the basement where it was a little cooler. You decide where you want to put it, if you want to put it in the house or in the sun or in the basement. You need to leave it overnight. Let the crystals grow. You can check it in a few hours, but the longer you wait, the larger your crystals will grow. And then you'll want to see what happens after you wait a couple of days too, and see if there's any difference. If you don't want to wait the full overnight, or if you still have some moisture left even after it's been overnight, you can just empty the excess out and see the crystal underneath. Now for the science. When you add Epsom salts to water, the salt dissolves. As the solution cools, the magnesium sulfate atoms in the Epsom salt run into each other and join together into a crystal structure. The crystals will be shaped like long needles and what you see here. Are you ready to experiment? Try making geodes in many different colors. Try putting some in the sun and some in the dark. You could take Epsom salts and put them into a pan instead of eggshells. You could try making other types of crystals. Alum powder can be found in the grocery store, and it would be fun to try to make crystals that look a little bit different than the Epsom salt crystals. Experiment with making crystals during the summer as a fun activity. I hope you really enjoy making these fake geodes. Crystals are amazing, and I hope you'll want to experiment with making crystals in lots of ways. See you next time with more science projects.